Good morning to our brothers and sisters of the Phnom Penh International Christian Church. And good morning to all our friends who are joining us today to worship God.
It is
just an honor for me and my wife Shelo to lead this church. Today, I just really want to ask, how are my brothers and sisters doing? As for me and my wife, we miss you all so much. And we can't wait for the day that we get to meet together again. The title of my lesson today,
An
unchanging God in a changing world. Let's all read in our Bibles in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. The Bible is very clear that our God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The Lord is our unchanging refuge and strength. Especially in this rapidly changing world. He is our anchor of our lives. Especially when we face many changes and uncertainties that can affect us deeply. Especially during this time, we're experiencing many changes. Because of this pandemic, everyone is experiencing many changes. Most people are now working from home. Many students are now studying from home through online classes. And now we're taking many precautions of washing our hands, wearing masks, and social distancing. And this new changes that we're experiencing is now becoming our new normal. And sometimes these changes can be traumatic. That's why we must rely on the unchanging God. Who is our sure foundation. We know that our Lord will be our faithful friend. And guide us through these periods of our lives. The first point, unchanging refuge. Let's all read in our Bibles in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 27. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. He will drive out your enemies before you, saying, destroy them. Here God has promised that us that He will never forsake us. And Jesus has experienced all of this, especially when He was put on the cross. We know all of His disciples had forsaken Jesus. But Jesus was able to gain reassurance from God. Knowing that God will never forsake him, especially in his time of loneliness.
nung nouchu mo yeh.
Today we can be reassured that our God will be with us.
Tu bai che yong bat bong away away tang all ru ko menu bong bong chal yeh pray men bong bong chal yeh te.
Despite us losing everything and people leaving us, we know that our God will not forsake us. Our families, our homes is one of our refuges during this time. And thank you God for the blessing of family.
In Matthew chapter 18 verse
20, let's all read together. For where two or three gather in my name, there am I with them. The Bible is very clear. When there are two or three that meet together, the Bible says that God is in the midst of them. They are the church. And that's why I just want to lift up all of our families in the church.
Krusarobo Kiamolin, Krusarobo di Tipana, Krusarobo Rexamaisraon, Krusarobo Kyom, Krusarobo Mingpan, Isoka, Ayum Chong Luk Dumkan, Sasa, Tian Muni Muir Boss of Yat, Deutsche, Tia Sharon, Tian Nick, Tia Bong Pro, then Pesca Chun, Tia Robo Bonsai, the Chief Pesca Chun Nai.
These are all our refuges. And I want to lift all of you up for staying faithful to God. And persevering and reading the Bible together, praying together, and today breaking the bread together. In Rome 8 verse
31,
the Bible says, if God is for us, who can be against us? We need to persevere, brothers and
sisters.
Because just as Solomon said, one day this will all pass. One day we'll all get to meet together again as a congregation. And we're going to be able to do the breaking of bread together, pray together, and just sing together.
Social media.
Today, let's continue to contact one another and reach out to one another through social media.
Messenger, Facebook, Zoom.
We can use our Messenger, our Facebook, Zoom. Let us not be lonely, let us not be alone.
And
I believe in this time of a time of being lonely and needing a friend, this is a time of needing a friend. Second point,
prayer.
Unchanging strength. Let's read in our Bibles in Jeremiah chapter 31 verse 3. The Lord appeared to us in the past saying, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. The Bible tells us that our Lord is our unchanging strength. Despite the people around us, their hearts will change. Their love can turn to hate. But the love of the Lord for us will never change. The Lord continues to be gracious towards us. The Lord continues to look at us with compassion. And His love will never change. I just want to lift up the elders in our church.
Despite
of them being older age, their love for the words and their love for the laws has never changed.
Ba ni ku chea kumru dai khom chong dah khuen bong paon dambei yum ai chap dam trap tam.
This is the example that I want to challenge everyone to follow.
Chumnoi ti 3.
The third point,
prakrom chea pdal dai at min ka prai prul.
Unchanging provider.
Samayo an prakampin dai khnung chatu kata chambu 8 ko 3 ta da 4.
Let's read in our Bibles in Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 3 to 4. He humbled you, causing you to hunger, and then feeding you with manna, which neither you nor your ancestors had known, to teach you that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Your clothes did not wear out, and your feet did not swell during these 40 years. Even when we fall in our finances, the Lord will continue to meet our needs. Even when we struggle financially, the Lord continued to provide for the Israelites in the desert during those 40 years. And during that time, they had no hope of any human help.
But the
Lord has never forsaken them, especially in their times of need. Today we should always be going to meet with the Lord so that He can meet our needs. Despite the situation being challenging or seem to be impossible, today, no matter how challenging your situation may be, I want to encourage you and challenge you for you to continue to pray to the Lord and stay faithful to Him. Let's continue to fight and seek and save the lost. That Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let's bow our heads and pray. Dear Father God in heaven, thank you for Jesus that continues to meet our
needs.
Thank you today that we're still alive and we have our
life.
Lord, be with us as we take the bread and the wine. Let's remember the love of God, of Jesus.
Tu mong ko maritan lang ako ni kung pre niyempre mo cha
priest. I pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.